وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
A questioner asked, what is the definition of al-Islam, al-Tawheed, la ilaha illallah, and worship? Please provide definitions in English and Arabic.
Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wa salatu wa salam ala abdillahi wa rasulih, nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Before answering this question, I think it is really important to note something about definitions in general. And that is to say that definitions exist in order to make understanding things easier. And generally, the early generation of Muslims would typically, rather than look for definitions that were jami'un mani', that were comprehensive and exclusive, they would usually give examples. Because the purpose of the definition was to assist and aid a person to understand. In later times, what happened is that people became very picky about definitions. They insisted that definitions be absolutely comprehensive and absolutely exclusive. And sometimes the definition might be actually more complicated than just understanding what is being said or just having an example given for what has been said. So the reason I started with that is just so that a person doesn't get lost in definitions and doesn't become confused by them. So if a definition is something that you are struggling to understand, it may be better to take an example from a definition that is looks at it from a different angle or gives a different kind of example. So with that being said, let us start with the definition of the word al-Islam. The definition of the word al-Islam. So al-Islam is al-istislamu lillahi bil-qabool wal-inqiyadu lahu bil-ta'a wal-bara'atu min ash-shirki wa ahli. Al-Islam is al-istislam. Al-istislam, it means submission. And a lot of people think that the word Islam means peace. However, the word Islam actually means al-istislam, submission. إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. When his Lord said to him, submit, he said, I have submitted to the Lord of the worlds. So the word Islam, it means al-istislam. Okay, submission to whom? Al-istislamu lillah, submission to Allah. Bil-qabool, with complete acceptance. Wal-inqiyadu lahu bi-ta'a, and submission to him or surrender to him in obedience. And when we say obedience, that includes doing everything that Allah commanded us to do and keeping away from everything that Allah commanded us to keep away from. So when you submit to Allah Azza wa Jal in Islam, that entails that you take on board the what comes out of that submission, which is obedience to Allah in doing what He commanded and keeping away from what He prohibited. Wal bara'atu min ash-shirki wa ahli, and being free of and disassociated from polytheism and its people. So if we go back again, submission to Allah with acceptance, surrender to Allah through obedience, and to be disassociated from and different from and distant from polytheism of all types, whatever kind of association of partner with Allah it is, and likewise from the people who do so. And that is one of the definitions that are put forward for Islam, and it's quite a comprehensive definition which gives us a good understanding of the word. So now let's come along to the word Tawheed. So the word Tawheed is a verbal noun from the verb wahada yuwahhidu. And wahhada in the language means to make something one or to consider something to be one. So when a country is unified, it becomes one, different states become one. They talk about tawheedu dawla, the time when the country became one. So this word tawheed, it means to be one, to believe something to be one, to affirm something as being one. Now when we look at the tawheed of Allah Azza wa Jal, we see that in a technical sense, we are talking about ifradullah ta'ala, that we're talking about Allah Azza wa Jal being alone in more than one aspect. In his rububiyyah, his lordship, so there is no one who does what he does. And in his worship, so there is no one deserving of worship except him. And in his names and attributes, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ, there is nothing like him and he is the all-hearing, the all-seeing. So when we bring these aspects together and we talk about إِفْرَادُ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ, making Allah عَزَّ وَجَلْ alone in his rububiyyah, in his uluhiyyah, in his asma and his sifat, then this is the meaning of at-tawheed in its most comprehensive sense, that Allah Azza wa Jal is alone in doing what he does, in his lordship, creation, command, giving life, causing death, decree and so on. Allah is alone in his right to be worshipped alone and with no partner. And Allah Azza wa Jal is alone in having his beautiful names and lofty attributes. So that takes us to the meaning of the word Tawheed. What about the definition of La ilaha illallah? So I'm not sure there's a definition in that sense of La ilaha illallah, but perhaps there's an explanation of La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah is made up of, is a sentence which is made up of two parts. The first part, La ilaha, and the second part, illallah. So La ilaha, it means there is no God, or there is no object of worship, because al-ilah in the Arabic language is al-ma'bud, that which is worshipped. So la ilaha, it means la ma'bud, there is nothing which is worshipped. Illallah, except Allah. Now, if we were to take the sentence like that, obviously the beginning is a nafi, it is to reject the worship of everything. And the second half is illallah, is ithbat, it is to affirm. But if we were to only take the rejection, we would be left with atheism. Because if a person were to say la ilaha and then stop without illallah, that would be atheism. And just to say that Allah is deserving of worship, that encompasses polytheism, because many polytheists worship Allah as well as others. So it's only when you say La ilaha illallah and you join between a nafi wal ithbat, between negation and affirmation, that you bring tawheed, you bring the oneness of Allah Azza wa Jal. It's also really important to say that there has to be a word that is understood from the sentence. Because if we say there is nothing that is worshipped except Allah, in reality, many things are worshipped besides Allah. People worship the sun and the moon, stones and trees and angels and prophets and the dead and the living. And people worship many things. So we have to have a word here which is understood from the sentence, which is the likes of bihaqqin. La ilaha a bihaqqin illallah. There is no God, there is no object of worship that is rightfully worshipped except Allah. There is no rightful object of worship except Allah. There is no true object of worship except Allah. As for the word worship itself, which is the last part of the question, what is the definition of worship? So worship is one of those things that it depends on what aspect of worship you look at. So there are some definitions of worship which looked at worship from a very broad sense. And from this is the definition of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala when he said, إِسْمٌ جَامِعٌ لِكُلِّ مَا يُحِبُّ اللَّهُ وَيَرْضَاهُ مِنَ الْأَقْوَالِ وَالْأَعْمَالِ الظَّاهِرَةِ وَالْبَاطِنَةِ. He said that it is a comprehensive term for everything that Allah loves and is pleased with, from statements and actions, whether internal or external. And that is a good definition of ibadah in the most loose and general sense of the word. Everything that Allah Azza wa Jal loves and is pleased with, whether statements or actions, whether open or hidden. That is a very good, comprehensive and detailed look at ibadah without narrowing it down to, for example, the ibadah which is which has its root in customs, or the ibadah which has its root in pure and absolute worship of Allah Azza wa Jal. So without sort of just looking at it from a general sense, that's a good definition. If we want to be a bit more specific and we want to look at it with a bit more of a, we want to kind of bring our focus in to exclude some of the things that that first definition brings in, and to bring in a more sort of precise definition which particularly focuses on the ibadat, which are pure ibadat, then perhaps the definition of the great scholar Al-Mu'allimi rahimahullah ta'ala when he said, خُضُوعٌ اِخْتِيَارِي يُطْلَبُ بِهِ نَفْعٌ غَيْبِي. He said, it is a voluntary submission or a voluntary humiliation, like someone to humble themselves completely and lower themselves completely, but to do so voluntarily. يُطْلَبُ بِهِ, seeking thereby, نَفْعٌ غَيْبِ, seeking thereby an unseen benefit, i.e. from the things which are only sought from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So voluntary humility or voluntary submission, seeking thereby a benefit from the benefits of the unseen. And ultimately, if you look at all of these definitions of worship, and really in a question like this, it's not really possible to answer in a very, very comprehensive way. But if you look at the different definitions of worship, what you see is that each one looks at it from a different angle and a different perspective. Some of them focus on ibadat, which are mahdha, which are absolute and pure, and they have no root in, you know, in customs and traditions and things like that. And some of them look at ibadah from a very broad perspective. Ibadat, which are mahdha and ghayr mahdha, which are absolute and those which are not. And so on. So here, these definitions, you have to take each one in the context that it was, in the context that it was given. But inshallah ta'ala, that's a good start anyway of a definition for Islam, for Tawheed, for La ilaha illallah, and for worship, which is ibadah. That's what Allah made easy for me to mention, and Allah knows best. Wassalatu wassalamu ala nabina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
If you have any questions you'd like to see answered as part of this series, and you can email us at questions@amau.org.